Welcome. You're watching the Newshour Agenda. I'm Padmaja Joshi, and we're starting with big, big news that is coming in from Kerala. A Congress leader in the state has been accused by none less than the chief minister of the state of being a potential super spreader. What's most shocking is that this leader of the Congress, who is also the bloc president, displayed symptoms of being corona positive as early as the 14th of March. He was told to be in quarantine by doctors. He even went for treatment at a private hospital, but he defied instructions to stay at home. And what is truly horrifying, he has traveled the length and breadth of Kerala, went for three large prayer meetings, even took part in a protest, and went to the Congress party office. This man finally tested positive yesterday. His test came back positive, but because of him now, 260 people he has been in touch with are under quarantine even as we speak. Two of them are in isolation wards. Listen in first to the very damning allegations that are being made against this leader of the Congress by the Kerala Chief Minister.
രോഗം സ്ഥിരീകരിച്ച ഇടുക്കിയിലുള്ള ഒരാളുടെ യാത്രയുടെയും സമ്പർക്കത്തിൻ്റെയും വിവരങ്ങൾ അമ്പരപ്പിക്കുന്നതാണ്. അദ്ദേഹം ഒരു പൊതുപ്രവർത്തകനാണ്. കാസർഗോഡ് മുതൽ തിരുവനന്തപുരം വരെ അദ്ദേഹം സഞ്ചരിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. തൊടുപുഴ, കട്ടപ്പന, അടിമാലി, എറണാകുളം, പെരുമ്പാവൂർ, പാലക്കാട്ട് ഷോളയൂർ, മൂവാറ്റുപുഴ, മൂന്നാർ, ഇങ്ങനെ യാത്ര ചെയ്ത സ്ഥലങ്ങളുടെ പട്ടിക അങ്ങ് നീളുകയാണ്. മെഡിക്കൽ കോളേജുകൾ, സ്കൂളുകൾ, പൊതുസ്ഥാപനങ്ങൾ, സെക്രട്ടേറിയറ്റ്, നിയമസഭാ മന്ദിരം, ഇങ്ങനെ സന്ദർശിച്ച സ്ഥാപനങ്ങളുടെ ലീസ്റ്റും ദൈർഘ്യമേറിയതാണ്. സമ്പർക്കം പുലർത്തിയ ആളുകളിൽ ഭരണാധികാരികളുണ്ട്, ജനപ്രതിനിധികളുണ്ട്, ഉന്നത ഉദ്യോഗസ്ഥരുണ്ട്, സമൂഹത്തിൻ്റെ വിവിധ തട്ടുകളിലുള്ളവരുണ്ട്.
You heard Pinaray Vijayan. Isn't it ironic that the Congress on one hand is attacking the center for being ill-prepared to tackle coronavirus and its spread, but its own leader is turning out to be a super spreader. The Kerala government has now put out a rough itinerary of how this man, in a complete breach of any common sense and concern for the lives of people, has travelled right across Kerala despite instructions. Let me bring in fact, Vivek Karandalam reporting live from Kerala, from Thiruvananthapuram. But before that, let me go across to Priya Behel, who's got, in fact, that itinerary, details of this man's itinerary put out by the state government. Over to you, Priya.
Right, Padmaja, so here is the document of the exhaustive travel history that has been released by the government of the route map of patient number 3 from Idukki, as they have called him. Now, see, this starts from 29th of February, as has been recounted by the person himself, but we will ignore all these places that he visited, giving him the benefit of doubt that he did not know that he was suffering from corona. But what is important is what happens after the 14th of March, because this is the date when he was clearly told that he has coronavirus. And despite that, look where all did he travel. He went to a funeral, then he traveled to Thodupura in a private car, then he attended a lunch the same day, which means three different functions on the day that he had been told that, listen, you have tested positive for coronavirus and you should be isolating yourself to avoid infecting other people. Then the next day, on 15th of March, he stays at home. On 16th, he decides to visit his party office. Then he also pays a visit to district hospital in Idukki. 18th March, 19th March, then 20th of March, he went to the local mosque. Then he went to J&K lab. Then finally, he was shifted to the hospital on 26th of March. So from 14th to 26th, 13 days, this man was out and about meeting people. And as we heard the Chief Minister of Kerala justifiably saying that this man has infected several other people. As we told our viewers, 260 people currently
absolutely
in quarantine.
Ridiculous. And you know what is worse? And I want to bring in Vivek Karindaram on this. This man now has the gall to put out a statement saying, I'm feeling very sad. So if I came in touch with you, please quarantine yourself. He's infected potentially 260 people and he's sad, Vivek.
Exactly, Padmaja. Now that he has come into a complete damage control mode, you know, where he has put out a statement with the press saying that, you know, he feels really sad and, you know, he has requested and his appeal to all his, followers and also well-wishers to stay in quarantine, especially in home quarantine and also to stay in isolation wards. Remember, he has traveled for 150 to 200 kilometers, traveled from Kasaragod to Thiruvananthapuram. He has met three MLAs in the assembly, also a cabinet minister. And, you know, and after that, he has also attended, prayers, not just once, but twice. And also, he has attended meetings, party meetings. And also on the 9th of March, he has also been part of a protest march in front of the secretariat. So he has come in contact with a large number of people, 260 people. And now, you know, in a damage control mode, he has put out a letter.
You know, makes one also think, because we also have seen a leader of the BJP from Kerala, KJ Alphonse, with us on the phone line. Mr. Alphonse, Kerala right now is one of the worst affected states. And you have a member of the Congress bloc president running around and meeting people despite being told to stay in quarantine. Shouldn't he be booked for negligence and endangering people's lives?
Yeah, certainly he should be. He should be booked. He should be arrested. Now, this is completely irresponsible. And we had a few cases like this, like in Pathanamthitta district. This was just about a month back. Somebody, a couple came from Italy with their son, and they didn't quarantine themselves. I think they got in touch. They went on a socializing spree and met over 800 people. And, of course, they felt sick eventually. So there are quite a few responsible people, as you see. And we have a very large number of people who come from abroad in those countries which have a very large number of coronavirus.
Hmm. So, and to think, sir, the potential of this man infecting people, because he's been for at least three large gatherings and a protest march, not to mention going to his own party office and the assembly.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very serious case. Obviously, he's not a very senior party functionary, but of course, he's been meeting a lot of people, taking part in a protest march, meeting, traveling all across the state. It's a very serious business.
Very, very serious. KJ Alphonse, we're certainly hoping that the Chief Minister of Kerala actually does act and take it up with the Congress party as well. We also have Mr. H. Dineshan, collector, now joining us on the phone line. Mr. Dineshan, can you please tell us how this gentleman managed to get out of his house despite clear medical advice that he was supposed to be in quarantine?
Good evening, ma'am. Actually, as far as Idukki district is concerned, ma'am, we have only three cases in Idukki. This particular positive case that is confirmed yesterday only. He was in quarantine from 15th. I think he traveled from the 1st March of this 13th, all over the Kerala, from the one end to the other, from Kasaragod to Trivandrum, actually. He participated in many programs of his political party program and other programs also. I think more than 1,000 primary contacts may be there.
1,000 contacts you are fearing that he may have had. Let me also ask you, are you contemplating legal action against him?
Ma'am, surely, ma'am. Sure. Because presently he is in hospital quarantine at Ishika Hospital, Thodupuzha, here in Idukki itself. After that, we will, no doubt, ma'am, we have to proceed legally also. The
All
thing
right,
is that, ma'am, he came to know that he is positive only on... Actually, he has no primary contacts with any positive case. That way, his argument is that he came to know that he is positive only yesterday.
But you can confirm to us that on the 15th, he was told very clearly that he should not venture out because he's showing symptoms?
Yes. I spoke to the doctor also. He gave a stricter direction that he should not be go out. He should be in home quarantine from 15 onwards. But despite that, he went out and met a lot of people.
Absolutely shocking. If this is not endangering others' lives, then what is? And for somebody who is a public representative, we certainly hope legal action is taken against him and the Congress also acts against this man. Thanks very much for having joined us, Mr. Dineshan, as well as Mr. KJ Alphonse. In fact, it's going to be a big debate at 10:30 as well. But the focus right now is on those people who in our country are the worst hit by the lockdown, those who are the poorest of the poor. Thousands of daily wage laborers across India are, even as we speak, marching from our cities to their villages. For some of them, their journey may be close to 500 to 800 kilometers. They carry their luggage, their children, their entire families with them. The reason? They have no job and they don't know where their next meal is coming from. Despite the measures from the center and the states, they're not willing to take a risk.
आप लोगों को कहीं कुछ खाने वाने के लिए
मिला? हाँ, मिला था
एक जगह मिला था
हाँ,
मिला तो ग्वालियर बस तो चल नहीं रही तो आप लोग फिर कैसे जाएंगे
पैदल जा रहे हैं सर
पैदल ग्वालियर जाएंगे
हाँ, सर।
तो आप लोगों को दिक्कत हो रही है रास्ते में
तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं है
लेकिन इतना लंबा रास्ता पैदल कैसे चलेंगे आप लोग
चलना ही पड़ेगा सर क्या करें मजबूरी हमारी
क्या करें सर यहाँ पे बेलदारी करते हैं ना खाना है ना पीना है यहाँ पे भूखे मर रहे हैं हम तीन दिन से तो हम लोग इसीलिए जा रहे हैं सर
हाँ बोला आप कहा वहाँ भूखकर मर जाए क्या करें बताओ ये तो हमारा कोई इंतजाम नहीं करा है हम लोग क्या करें बताओ
खाने के लिए तो इंतजाम सरकार कर रही है
ना तो उनको कर रही है सड़कों पर कर चली जा रही कोई अंदर थू कर रही है अंदर जा रहे हैं हम उन लोगों को कौन जानता है
खाने पीने की परेशानी है पर। काम धंधा नहीं है कोई और
करीब 70 किलोमीटर चल चुके हैं अभी हम गाजियाबाद के पैदल ही जाएंगे क्या करें साहब
क्या करते हैं
पुलिस का काम करते हैं रोज कमाते हैं रोज खाते हैं क्या करें पैसे नहीं है कि जाना पड़ेगा कोई सुविधा भी नहीं कर रही सरकार हमारी
आज तीन दिन हो गए कुछ भी नहीं मिला बाहर निकल रहे तो पुलिस मार रही है कि घरों में रहो ना कोई साग सब्जी कुछ भी नहीं है तो इसीलिए मजबूरी में निकलना पड़ा है
The thing is this a problem that can be tackled by a government alone? Because after the Prime Minister's appeal, multiple people from companies to civilians to even policemen have come forward to help in their own way. But the politics continues.
ये नवरात्रि का जब प्रारंभ हुआ है तब अगले 21 दिन तक प्रतिदिन 9 गरीब परिवारों की मदद करने का प्रण लें 21 दिन तक 9 परिवारों को आप संभालें मैं मानता हूं अगर इतना भी हम कर लें तो मां की इससे बड़ी आराधना क्या हो सकती है ये सच्चा और पक्का नवरात्र हो जाएगा
The 20,000 crore project instead of redevelopment of the Central Vista project should be used for rehabilitation, relocation of the 48 crore labor force which have not got any help from the central government till date.
The Congress party and its leadership has just one agenda. Criticize Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji personally or criticize his government and anything that the government does.
All right, joining us on the debate, who is going to take care of those who need it most at this time? We have Shrikant Sharma, Power Minister of Uttar Pradesh, joining us live, spokesperson of BJP Shazia Ilmi, author Advaita Kala, national spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party Raghav Chadda, leader of the CPI Dr. Dinesh Vashne and political analyst Nishant Verma. But I want to ask you first, Shrikant Sharma, because most of the people in North India, jo ki yahan shahron ko chhod karke ja rahe hain, agar wo teen rajya hain jahan wo ja rahe hain, बिहार झारखंड उत्तर प्रदेश दिल्ली के सबसे करीब उत्तर प्रदेश है इनके वेलफेयर के लिए उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार क्या कर रही है
अपने घर पे रहें सुरक्षित रहें यही अपील देश के प्रधानमंत्री ने की है क्योंकि ये बहुत बड़ा संकट है और इस संकट से हम सबको मिलकर लड़ना है ये बीमारी है ये वायरस फैल रहा है इसको रोकने के लिए हमारी देश की जो 130 करोड़ लोगों की जो सेना है इन सबको एक साथ जुटना पड़ेगा बहुत बड़ी चुनौती है बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है उत्तर प्रदेश में कहीं कोई रात को भूखा ना सोए। प्रधानमंत्री जी की मंशा है कि गरीब के घर में चूल्हा जले, उसकी चिंता हमारी सरकार कर रही है। हमारे यहाँ दो कैटेगरी के श्रमिक हैं, एक ऐसे श्रमिक हैं जो रजिस्टर्ड हैं, एक 15 लाख ऐसे हैं जो रजिस्टर्ड नहीं हैं। 20,35,000 हमारे यहाँ श्रमिक हैं जो रजिस्टर्ड हैं, उनके खातों में 1,000 रुपये हम पहुँचा रहे हैं। उनको खाना मिले इसकी चिंता हम कर रहे हैं। उनके लिए, उनके परिवारों के लिए 20 किलो गेहूं, 15 किलो चावल, दाल उनके घरों में पहुंचे इसकी चिंता हम लोग कर रहे हैं। सभी जिलाधिकारियों को ये निर्देश दिए गए हैं कि जिले में कहीं पर भी कोई गरीब आदमी, कोई हमारा मजदूर भाई रात को बिना खाने के ना सोए, इसकी हम लोग चिंता कर रहे हैं। तो सरकार की तरफ से पूरी तैयारी है, लेकिन ये ऐसा एक संकट है जिसमें हमारे पास पूरा हमारा जो मुल्क है, हम चीन, अमेरिका और ब्रिटेन से मुकाबला नहीं कर सकते। वहाँ उनके यहाँ मेडिकल फैसिलिटीज बहुत ज़्यादा हैं, उसके बावजूद भी वहाँ वो उसको रोकने में विफल रहे हैं।
पर मिस्टर शर्मा, मेरे को ये बताइए, आप जो श्रमिक उत्तर प्रदेश में हैं उनका ध्यान आप रख रहे हैं, उनको आप 1,000 रुपये देंगे, पर जो उत्तर प्रदेश के निवासी हैं, जो महाराष्ट्र में है, दिल्ली में है, उनका ख्याल कौन रखेगा? उनके लिए तो ऐसी स्थिति है जैसे आगे कुआं पीछे खाई। यहाँ बीमारी है, उधर पुलिस वाला है।
हमने हमारा जो हमारे जो मुख्यमंत्री हैं, उन्होंने महाराष्ट्र के मुख्यमंत्री से बात की है और दूसरे राज्यों के मुख्यमंत्रियों से बात की है, दिल्ली में हमारी बात हुई है। जो उत्तर प्रदेश के निवासी हैं उनका जो खर्चा है उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार वहन करेगी, लेकिन इस अभियान में राजनीति नहीं होनी चाहिए। हम सब मिलकर इस लड़ाई को लड़ें, और ये बहुत बड़ा मुल्क है हमारा, और ये संकट ऊपर से आया है, और इस संकट में सबसे बड़ा जो निदान है वो सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का है, कि सोशल डिस्टेंस जितना ज्यादा रखेंगे उतना ज्यादा हम लोग कारगर होंगे। तो आज किसी पर आरोप प्रत्यारोप का विषय नहीं है, जहाँ जहाँ जो जो लोग हैं
इसमें राजनीति की जरूरत नहीं है, पर एक सबसे बड़ा इल्जाम ये लगाया जा रहा है कि लोगों की हालत ऐसी नहीं होती अगर पहले से तैयारी की गई होती, उनको वार्निंग दी गई होती। केंद्र ने बिना किसी वार्निंग के इन लोगों के ऊपर इतना बड़ा बॉम्ब फोड़ दिया, आप क्या कहेंगे?
देखिए, ये आरोप गलत है, मैं इसको सही नहीं मानता, और पूरी तैयारी की है, क्योंकि एक संकट है और संकट में जितनी तैयारी बेस्ट टू बेस्ट हो सकती है वो किया है। अब 1,70,000 करोड़ का पैकेज है, सभी राज्यों को 3 महीने का एडवांस में राशन का व्यवस्था की गई है। 80 करोड़ परिवार हैं, उनको 5 किलो गेहूं, 5 किलो चावल, 1 किलो दाल उनको मिलती रहे एक्स्ट्रा, इसकी चिंता सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट कर रही है। तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट आपको सुविधा दे सकती है, आपको पॉलिसी दे सकती है, आपको पैसा दे सकती है, तो उसको एग्जीक्यूट करना तो राज्यों का काम है। और बड़ी शिद्दत के साथ हम लोग उसको नीचे एग्जीक्यूट कर रहे हैं। अब गैस के सिलेंडर सरकार दे रही है, लगभग 8 करोड़ 30 लाख परिवार हैं, उनको गैस के सिलेंडर सरकार मुफ्त में 3 महीने के लिए दे रही है केंद्र सरकार। तो बहुत सारे इनिशिएटिव सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से लिए गए हैं, उनका ठीक से नीचे इम्प्लीमेंटेशन हो जाए, ये काम केवल राज्य सरकारों को करना है।
मैं आखिरी सवाल आपसे ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि प्रधानमंत्री ने अपना जो देश को एड्रेस किया था, उन्होंने कहा था कि नवरात्रों के दौरान आप 9 परिवारों का ख्याल 9 दिन के लिए रखिए, क्या ये भी एक तरीका है जिससे कम से कम कुछ लोगों को मदद पहुंचाई जा सके? क्या आप उस बात की अपील करना चाहेंगे कि अपनी हैसियत से, अपने लेवल पर हर कोई करे?
डेफिनेटली, ये एक ऐसा युद्ध है, इसमें हम सबको अपनी जिम्मेदारी भी निभानी है। सरकार अपने स्तर पर जो काम कर रही है वो कर रही है, लेकिन हम की स्वयं की हमारी जिम्मेदारी हमारे समाज के प्रति, देश के प्रति क्या है? ये एक बहुत बड़ा एक मैं कहूँगा कि उन्होंने एक एडवाइस दिया है, उसके मुताबिक सभी लोग लगे हैं। बहुत सारे सामाजिक संगठन मैडम जमीन पर काम कर रहे हैं, और एक पॉजिटिव स्टोरी ये भी है कि नीचे अगर आप देखें तो बड़ी तादाद में लोगों को राहत देने का भी काम समाज के एनजीओज कर रहे हैं, समाज के और संगठन कर रहे हैं, जिनके माध्यम से कोई रात को भूखा नहीं सो पा रहा है। तो सरकार और सामाजिक संगठन मिलकर इस अभियान को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं।
श्रीकांत शर्मा, थैंक यू वेरी मच for speaking to us specifically about the people who are from Uttar Pradesh and people who are headed to Uttar Pradesh, because this is a big, big humanitarian crisis. Let me bring in our panel. Raghav Chadda, do you agree with this sentiment that this is not the time for politics because the migrants cannot be nowhere people? Wo honge bhale se hi Uttar Pradesh ke, par abhi wo reh Delhi mein rahe hain. To aapas mein coordination zaruri hai. Raghav Chadda.
A couple of quick things. First of all, after having interacted with those who are migrating back to their villages, the ministers of the government, the MLAs, etc., have come to one conclusion, and I'm pretty sure that your reporters who've interacted with them have also arrived at the same conclusion, that they are not leaving Delhi because there is inadequate arrangement of their food or inadequate arrangement of boarding and lodging facility. They are leaving the town simply because there is this fear of permanent absence of the earning capacity, livelihood and work opportunity for foreseeable future in Delhi, coupled with a panic of this outbreak of the disease, and they feel that they can spend and live and sustain a life and a family in their villages during this lockdown, and as long as this outbreak continues, and they're finding it difficult to live in these metros and cities. Now, our appeal to them, and the Honorable Chief Minister also in his press conference made this appeal, that Delhi is your town, Delhi is your state, Delhi is your home. Please do not leave Delhi. Appropriate arrangements for your boarding and lodging as well as food have been made. Appropriate arrangements for your enhancing your earning capacity, providing you with an employment opportunity in the times to come will also be made. So please do not leave Delhi. I think this is something that nobody could have anticipated, that suddenly there will be thousands and thousands of people who would leave, who would migrate back from their from Delhi back to their villages. I think this is extremely unprecedented, very, very worrying. And what really, sends shivers down our spine is that here is a state of panic and fear where people are willing to walk.
But let me ask you this, Raghav Chadda, who deals with this? Do you think that we have to deal with it at multiple levels? Or should it be addressed by center, state, corporates, individuals?
Look, let me say this in no uncertain terms, that it's a collective responsibility. Everybody needs to play a role in this. And as far as ensuring that the borders are sealed and ensuring that nobody, no movement is allowed around the borders, no interstate transport is allowed, of course, that responsibility happens to be with the Delhi police and not with the civil administration of the government of Delhi. But these are not times for putting the blame on one agency or the other. I mean, I have been for a very long time maintaining that whether it's the Lieutenant Governor, the Delhi Police, or the Aam Aadmi Party run Delhi government, all three agencies, arms of the government, have been working in close coordination, and the functioning has been extremely smooth. Now, you know, this migration back to their villages also defeats the larger purpose of the lockdown, because the idea was that everybody stays indoors in their houses. Now, if God forbid somebody has been infected with this disease and he reaches, he or she reaches back to his village, the disease may spread in the in that village.
Agreed. And I'm pretty, so then, Shazia, tell me, what is the bigger plan? Because if people are going to be migrating in droves, where is the lockdown?
Medical facilities in these villages are not.
Yes, which is why it was important for the, I mean, the priority of saving lives and livelihoods was that there has to be isolation of people. That was the whole idea, which is why the flights and the passenger trains were cancelled, which is why, the essential services, their provisions had to be made for them to be given directly to the people. But because there are no shelters and places to stay for the contract laborers, for the migrant workers, and because the local thekedars, wherever they're working, whether it's construction site or other places, they don't, and normally they make their own small place. It's a makeshift arrangement, and that's where they work. But because there is no, scope for them for subsistence, which is why they're rushing off. So I think it was important to convey to them that wherever they are, they could have stayed. The local schools and the Sarkari hospitals and schools could have given them shelter. But somehow the people want to just feel, people feel that there is, there will be no form of income. And they will,
many are arguing maybe that preparation whatsoever could have been done beforehand, Raghav Chadda.
Yeah.
No, I don't think so. I think the government did
look,
what
first
it
of
did,
all,
and it, that was very
let
important.
Me, let me
know,
make a quick
COVID-19
few points. First of all, more than 560 locations in Delhi. Now, Padmaja, may I respond?
Yes, please.
Padmaja, may I interject now?
Yes, okay. Go on.
So, roughly 560 places in Delhi have been have been converted into night shelters. There are 560 places spread across the length and breadth of Delhi in every nook and corner of Delhi, literally covering every locality where the poor, the destitute, the downtrodden live, where appropriate arrangements for night shelters and their boarding and lodging has been made. About 240 were there as permanent night shelters. Everyone is aware of those locations. That has been scaled up to 550. The number can still be increased.
If there are enough shelters, then why are people not staying there?
As I explained, I didn't know.
So I think what we yes. should facilitate is to ensure.
Well,
that
Padmaja, if you heard my opening statement carefully, and if you understood what I was trying to say, that they're not leaving for lack of facility to live, or how boarding or lodging or for food, there is a
that's
fear
not entirely
of
correct
a
because actually a large number of them keep saying, "Khane ko nahi hai, khane ko nahi hai."
Of an outbreak.
I mean, you know, we had than, those testimonies than, of people.
Well, that no. That what they please understand. Well, I will supplement my argument. Like if, for example, if somebody is willing to walk 700 kilometers to get a full meal at their village, they could have easily walked 1.5 to 2 kilometers to reach the nearest night shelter or the food facility that the government of Delhi has set up. That is not the argument. Please interact with them extensively. Try and understand what they're trying to say. They are not talking about when they say khano ko nahi hai, they're not talking about their immediate next meal. They have that food. That food arrangement has been made by the government of Delhi. What they're trying to highlight, and the deputy chief minister of Delhi was traveling across Delhi, meeting these people all throughout the day.
Okay.
And they very clearly explained that what they're talking about is a fear of a permanent absence or lack of a work opportunity in zero earning capacity for foreseeable future, coupled with this panic of outbreak. These were the reasons which were given to us. And okay. Please understand.
So let me open this up also.
More
let
than
me,
four,
let
four
me
and
open
a half
this
lakh
up.
People are being fed on a daily basis.
Okay, so there
in
is
fact,
enough food, you
channel.
Say. It is the
may
fear
just,
and the lack of opportunity. So
it
let me ask you this, as a citizen's voice, Advaita Kala,
night shelters
what should
and
be
reported
done?
That there is impact.
Because the fact
may I just finish, Padmaja?
Okay, finish your point.
May I just finish my point?
Yeah, go on.
May I just finish my point? It is your channel that did a story. Your reporter went to one of our night shelters and reported that food arrangements have been made. People are happy with the arrangement. They are living their lives peacefully. Boarding and lodging arrangements have been made. Your channel did that story. People were happy. It is not because of an absence of the facility. It is because
I
they
agree.
Fear that they have no future in Delhi and
I
they
agree,
can live
but
a life.
Also a multiplicity
a
of such voices. I mean, if you like, I can play plenty of more voices also who are saying that here there is no food here. I can't make that up either. So there are all kinds
I
of people.
Explain that to
those
you,
who are happy
you
with your night shelters, without a doubt, are continuing in Delhi. But then there are also
about
thousands.
Is not their next meal, Padmaja.
There are also thousands who are moving out. And this is not about a political blame game, which is why I'm bringing in the citizen voices as well. So tell me this, Advaita Kala, how can this fear and panic be addressed? Because the fact is, in a lockdown, yes, there is a loss of jobs, especially for daily wages. What can be done?
You know, I think the first step is really just humility, because even big governments, rich governments, big cities like New York City, you know, have really fallen to their knees, because this is an overwhelming pandemic, and it has tested every capability that we have, that we've built across geographies. And that would include a city like Delhi. It includes a city like New York. You know, so there may be shelters, there may be hospitals, there may be beds. We have to face up to the reality that it's not going to be enough. And this is why the Prime Minister kept saying, you know, prepare, don't panic, is because whatever we have at this point of time, whatever we've tried to do in the last couple of days, will still not be enough. And this is really the fight for coronavirus, or against coronavirus rather, is not just a fight of governments. It's a fight of citizens. It's a fight of the media as well, in terms of the news that you put out there, the information that you put out there. I think we have to all just really come in and try and help. I think it is a moment for private-public partnerships. I know in Gurugram, where I live, a group of us have come together in a community initiative called Janta Rasoi. And we've taken the pledge that no one in Millennium City with our skyscrapers and underpasses is going to sleep hungry. Of course, the government is supporting us. They've reached out to us. We've reached out to them. The Gurudwaras are supporting. We're all in it together. So I think rather than getting into a blame game on what the government can do, cannot do, I think it's important to chip in whatever way
exactly.
that we can.
That is a fabulous example. And that's where I want to bring in Nishant Verma and Dinesh Vashnaya both. Nishant Verma, public, private, partnership, but please no politics. Is this the time?
Well, as far as I understand, the program started in a toner that I thought we will be trying to set the liabilities and responsibilities.
Mm-hmm.
Reason being, lockdown hai aur hum logon ko sabko ek dusre ki madad to karni hai. But liabilities and responsibilities set karni zaruri hai. We heard Shrikant Sharma, we heard Raghav Chadda, we heard Shazia Elmi. Let's understand the liability setup.
Yes.
WHO, whom we were earlier mocking way back in January and February, I was there on debates, declared the global health emergency on 30th January 2020. On 22nd of March 2020, we went into a Janta curfew followed by what we are today, which is a very good thing as of now. The governments, plural, had sufficient time to plan, and I'm not saying Mr. Modi and Mr. Yogi, they are nobody to plan, they have a vision, we have seen the results. It is the bureaucracy which plans.
Plans what?
And takes the legal and the political will.
You've got two people, representative political parties saying, yes, we have planned, and we have got shelters ready.
Please allow me, try to understand, this is no... We are not here to fight. Please try to understand. On 30th January 2020, WHO declares a global health emergency.
Sir, answer my question. Plan what?
We had 1.5 months. Plan what? Plan the livelihood, survival for next 2 months, 3 months,
How will you plan the livelihood for somebody who's a construction worker?
The migrants.
When construction is not taking place, how will you give him livelihood?
Who does it?
What alternative livelihood will you give him?
I'm sorry?
What alternative livelihood will you give to a construction worker?
That's what
worker?
The government to decide. If they can't put nyay into place,
Nishan
that's
ji,
what they're doing.
Nishan ji,
what kind of a question is this?
And they I want to say to you at place. This point of time, while I know you mean well, and all of us do, but you know, this is a pandemic of such magnitude. And I think, as Advaita said, nothing would be enough. And I'm whether it's Orissa government,
was sleeping since
or is Punjab government,
20.
Or is the Delhi government,
stop doing
or
this,
is the UP
Shazia
government,
stop
whether
doing
is
this
the
to
control
us.
Rooms,
we
whether
are
is the highway patrolling
we
or the policing,
in order to make
I
sure that the
Nishanji,
country gets COVID-19
as,
out of us.
I agree with Raghav when Raghav says it's a collective responsibility. And you know, I also realize, I mean, it breaks my heart to say nothing would be enough.
You need an escape
when
route.
I see these pictures,
see,
because
the
it's very difficult to
we
go out there and convince the people
the lockdown
to stay
is there.
Put.
We are at home. Padmaja
so
Ji, on 23rd
feel,
of March, I was driving back from Agra to Delhi, and I raised this
more.
Yamuna
Let's see
Expressway
what can we do
filled
now.
With thousands of people walking back. Mr. Shrikant
yes.
Sharma has not said one word of taking these people home.
Sir, actually the UP government has officially issued orders saying that everyone working on that expressway and going to the border should be given food and water.
There are numbers given on which they can call, and their buses being plied on a daily basis to pick them up. And there are many such things.
What is about
you have to be
and if you also read more, there is also a highway task force. But specifically on the issue, and I want to bring two issues back to Raghav Chadda. Raghav Chadda, A, you've got people asking, why didn't you plan alternative employment for those who would be left without a job by this shutdown? And B, they are saying that whatever is being done is not enough. That's what the statement put out by the Politburo, the CPI today says. Yes, you've got these rain baseras, but rain baseras are not enough, and anyway, you're not practicing social distancing there.
Well, first of all, social distancing is being practiced. This has been reported across the media, where pictures, videos, sound bites of people who are living there comfortably were taken, and all social distancing norms are being complied with. And if there are some lapses here or there, we would be more than happy to be notified of those lapses, and we will certainly rectify and bring changes wherever it's required. And I mean, whether it's the media, whether it's our opposition parties, we welcome their criticism in that sense. Number one.
To Delhi because number they two, did not have opportunities
appropriate
back in the rural
arrangements
area
have been met. May I just
now you expect them to go back?
May I? Why is he verbal heckling me? Can I, Padmaja?
No,
may
I am asking you, sir.
These people come to cities like Delhi
and Mumbai.
I don't usually show up on these shows because I don't wish to use my lung power.
Okay, just a second, Mr. Varma. These are not ideal times. Yes, people have turned up because of lack of opportunity, but these are not ideal times. Finish your point, Raghav Chadda. Yes, finish your point.
Well, Padmaja, I believe in civility. I participate only in civil debates, and I hope that decorum will be maintained and the gentleman who was verbal heckling me can be given an opportunity once I conclude my argument. The fact is that appropriate arrangements for their boarding and lodging and supplies of food have been made. There is no, and if at all there is requirement for more boarding and lodging, we can scale it up from 240 to 550. The number of night shelters have been increased in a span of less than 24 hours. These are extraordinary times. These call for extraordinary measures. Nobody saw this lockdown coming. I mean, somebody mentioned that why were alternative employment opportunities were made. I mean, how stupid can one get with one's arguments? I mean, at this point in time, nobody is employed. All employment, all businesses, all operations, everything is shut.
Exactly.
What I'm talking of is of future, that we are trying to give them assurance that look, these are times of fear and panic. We understand that you may be undergoing these,
yes,
and you may fear that there is a permanent absence of an earning opportunity of work, an earning capacity. We will ensure that you have gained meaningful employment once the lockdown concludes. Please do not leave these cities. Delhi is your own city.
And,
we are doing that.
And,
in fact,
Dr.
the Dineshan deputy Vashne, chief minister,
because you have
the
a large cadre,
person in the government,
wherever you see
was
that
doing
there
rounds
are
all
gaps
across
in the
border.
Government's preparation. Why don't you use your cadre to plug those gaps? If you can have individuals like Advaita Kala, policemen
in
PCR vans going around distributing food packets,
Raghav, I have sent a letter to Arvind Kejriwal ji today, and I have sent the copy of that letter to Raghav Chadda WhatsApp number also. He can read it. First of all, I am very sorry to say these shelter or night shelters do not
have
that much of sufficient space to house 4 lakh people, which Kejriwali ji is saying that tomorrow we will distribute the food to 4 lakh people with the norm of social distancing. Forget about social distancing. Otherwise, you cannot house them in 4 lakh people without opening the stadium and school buildings and other government buildings which are empty and facilities. Number two, you have to increase your food center and sufficient food has to be supplied. Yesterday, you made a lathi charge at the Nigam Bodhghat night shelter because food finished. The sufficient food supply is not there. I am not, you are doing what, but you have to do more. Every corporation ward should have 5 or 6 night shelters of 2,000 or 3,000 each. 5 or 6 centers, similarly for food. If you house them in the Indira Gandhi Indoor Stadium or other indoor stadium or bigger stadium, they have a toilet facility in
Raghav Chadda wants to respond to that, and then I will bring in Shazia Almin, Advaita Kala as well. Raghav Chadda, yes.
Yeah, I'll briefly respond.
And number three, now
look,
we are using
look, first of all, I haven't received any such letters that he is talking about. Even if he has sent such letter, and even if he's suggesting about converting stadiums into places of distributing food, etc., of course, we can certainly look into these suggestions. Having said that, the entire might of the civil administration, Padmaja, is on the ground ensuring that nobody sleeps without having a proper meal. In fact, all MLAs, including myself, I, in every nook and corner of my Vidhan Sabha, have set up small kitchens. I mean, we have identified 9 places. I myself have identified 9 places in my Vidhan Sabha, Rajendranagar Assembly constituency, where the poor, the downtrodden, the destitute live. And lunch and dinner is being organized and being served to them. This is over and above.
No, but the Professor Dineshan Vashne is saying that there wasn't enough food and the poor were lathi charged.
So the in all...
Look, Raghav, I agree that you are doing. Raghav, I agree that you are doing. But please try to understand. I don't wish to get into this back and forth. If he has any suggestions, because their dietary pattern is higher than the middle income group and higher middle income group. You have to supply them a food of at least cooked food of 250 grams.
If you have any suggestions, you can send your suggestions to me.
I have sent them. I have sent them today to Kejriwalji. Well, I sent a letter to Mr. Manish Sisodia 2 days ago also.
We'll be more than happy to look into it.
I agree with Varshney ji. He's giving a positive input and it should be considered. But I think the priority right now is really to reach out, because the most affected, and it's, yes, I mean, correct. It's visibly so distressing to see this kind of exodus. I have not seen these visuals in a long, long time of just people, the reverse migration that we see happening. So something has got to give, and we have to reach out, whether it's through media or public
announcements. And again, I'm saying, if individuals can do it, Professor Vashne, why can the left not step in? अगर आपको लगा निगम बहुत घाट में कम कम खाना है, आप थोड़ा सा खाना पहुंचा दीजिए सर. दिल्ली में आप भी रहते हैं ना?
Government, let the
आप भी दिल्ली में रहते हैं?
Let the Delhi.
आप कोई पेरिस से तो आए नहीं है. आपके भी उतने ही लोग हैं जितने राघव चड्ढा के हैं या शाजिया इल्मी के हैं.
पद्मजा सुनोगे भी या नहीं करोगे? ट्रांस यमुना में भी हम कर रहे हैं. जहां जहां पे हमारी पार्टी ब्रांचेज है वहां पे हम कर रहे हैं. हमारे लोगों को पास नहीं मिल रहा. जहां जहां पे पुलिस ने अलाउ कर दिया वहां हम डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं फूड. यू कैन इंक्वायर.
दैट इज वेरी काइंड ऑफ यू सर, एंड प्लीज कंटिन्यू टू डू इट.
ओनली थिंग इज वी आर नॉट टेकिंग अवर फ्लैग्स एंड नॉट टेकिंग अवर बैजेस. वी डोंट वांट टू पॉलिटिसाइज दिस.
यस प्लीज डोंट डू दैट. इट्स नॉट
दिस इज नॉट
एग्जैक्टली द पॉइंट.
पॉलिटिसाइज इट.
एग्जैक्टली द पॉइंट. अद्वैता काला.
वी आर डूइंग इट एंड विल कंटिन्यू टू डू इट.
अद्वैता काला. एंड यू नो इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल थिंग एंड आई रियली हैव टू से दिस दैट मेनी पीपल स्नियर्ड एट इट. बट व्हेन द प्राइम मिनिस्टर सेड दैट टेक अ 9-day प्लेज. Don't do it because it's Navratra or whatever. Just take a 9-day pledge and say, I will feed 9 families around me. This is a more realistic way of getting things done rather than saying, Sarkar karegi, hum Twitter pe criticize karenge. Adwaita Kala.
Absolutely. I mean, we have to support the governments in the states, in the different states. This is unprecedented. No one is going to be prepared enough. It's a continuing battle. It's going to continue for a while. We have to chip in and do what we can. And I frankly think the Prime Minister has been prescient. You know, when he talked about open defecation and he talked about Swachhata, a lot of people were sneering. But look at the reality today. You know, the virus stays the longest in fecal matter. Look at the fact that we are able to do whatever direct transfers that we are able to do because everybody, or most of the population now, has that zero balance account. So I think really, you know, there will be enough time to set blame, to do an analysis. But at this point of time, it's an all hands on deck approach, wherein whoever has the resources, the time, the contacts must come forward and help their respective governments. And sure, we can fix accountability. There will be a time for that as well. But right now, we just have to help people, and really nobody in any part
Mr.
of this country
must
sleep hungry.
If you must, please come up with solutions. Everyone knows we have a problem. It's not hidden from anyone. Before you answer, sir, I want to quickly get in a few viewers as well, because we're asking a simple thing. Can you help people around you, or are you going to sit back and wait for the government to act and then criticize? Sunil from Bengaluru has called in. Yes, Sunil.
Very good evening, ma'am. What I would like to say is, it's my day 3 lockdown today. And my request to the government and the state governments only is, tell your temples, tell your all the, you know, places where the lockers are there, open their lockers and start helping people. Because as Sai Baba Samiti did today, They have given 55 crores. So let all the temples come out and give money to the poor, or start serving food to the people.
That's
when
a
they
very
need.
Good point. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, there are some gurdwaras, etc., in Delhi, which are doing that as well.
That's right.
All right. We've got Pooja also with us on the phone line from Delhi. Yes, Pooja, can you help?
So I can hear. Really, thank you for getting us all the information. And what I'm seeing is this was a total outbreak, which was unexpected, actually. And I just feel that maybe if the police or the army or somebody has more secure measures can step in. I'm totally with Raghav that I'm into the news 24/7, and I'm seeing the government is really going out and out.
And good.
Help.
And good. You know, I mean, I think this is a very, very rare occasion where you actually see cooperations between states. Which is why, like we said, if you see something that can be done better, the army is doing it, the police is doing it, individuals are doing it. Finally, do you have one constructive suggestion for both the politicians sitting here on the panel, Nishant Verma? Give one constructive suggestion to each.
Well, the... Okay. I will not discuss anything, but only one thing. Get the arrangements in place. Could it be central or any state government or corporation? Don't let people migrate unnecessarily. They will carry probably the disease and they may not be able to reach their destinations in a proper manner. It's a summer time. Please make arrangements. Please give them money, because I understand Mr. Prime Minister has requested us to help 9 families, but most of us are having month end, no job or no salaries. It may not be that easy. It has to be a public and private partner and the government partnership, as we say. But yes, governments, plural, get people either home or back. Don't start thinking now about placing them where you had sufficient time and you still have tonight to do it. Do it by tomorrow morning.
Sir, Vipda kabhi bata karke nahi aati, aisa kaha jata hai. But anyway, I'm sure aap zyada doordarshi hain. Yes.
Vipda 30 January ko aa
gayi. Do you think that could be a centralized
Vipda
way of doing this?
Vipda 30 January 2020 ko aa gayi thi.
I think better coordination is definitely needed. I would really like to reach out right now and say that instead of, I think we should cross these very shallow barriers of parties at this point of time. I really want to, personally, I think whether it's Orissa government, Punjab government, Delhi government and UP government, they've done a tremendous job in setting up control centers, providing food and shelter. But I think somehow, I would tend to agree with one point that Nishant made, that this exodus and this kind of migration must stop. I don't know whether it's the stateway, the highway patrolling or police to tell them that they could carry infection. One, they could take it back there. And it's going to be an ordeal. Somehow it has to be contained. This exodus or this migration has to be stored in a positive way. So that kind of messaging still needs to be given.
Bring them
so
back
I think
by
all states
buses,
need to work on that very seriously.
Shelters,
okay, we've got,
stadiums.
And you know the only way to do it, to be very honest with you, things like stay where you are, maintain social distancing, is a bit of a luxury when you are completely uncertain about how long it is before you get your next job. So one also has to see from their point of view. But finally, Adwaita, what is the way out? Because I don't want to take the last word from any political analyst. What is the way out, or will people just have to grin and bear it?
You know, Padmaja, there are very few moments in history when you can serve your country. Very few of us will ever serve in uniform, because, that is not an opportunity that hopefully will ever arise, where the general public is drafted and those kind of situations come up. This is an opportunity to serve your country. It's an invisible enemy, but it is no lesser than a war. And at war times, like in all great countries, with all great people, you stand by each other, you help each other, you do your best, and you stay positive, because this too shall pass. And we shall overcome this. We are bound to overcome this. We're an ancient civilization. We've overcome far, far more. And we have to stand by each other at this time. There's really no other way out of this.
And, always remember, this is not a problem that is limited to India alone. Across the world, wherever there is the corona infection, there are thousands of homeless who still are grappling with A, the threat of infection, and also with lack of food. So every country has this problem. Yes, we should keep pushing the government to help as much as possible. Let's do our little bit as well, at least for the 9 days. For not religious reasons, for purely humanitarian reasons. Thank you very much, all gentlemen, Adwaita Kala, Shazi Almi, for having joined me. Again, thanking you today in the hope of a better week to come. Thanks for watching.